Hi, this is Mark Johnson. I'm one of the producers of the Chronicles of Narnia, The Voyage of the Dawn Treader. I produced also the first two, Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe, and Prince Caspian, and with me is Michael Apted.
Yes, I'm Michael Apted, and I directed Dawn Treader. And what we're looking at here is the visual effects of the opening scene, which, as you can see, when we shot it, was just a big blue screen. And then we got these wonderful stills of King's College, Cambridge. That was my alma mater, that university, so I know and love it well. And you can see how we then added, in Australia where we shot the blue screen, we added period cars and people, pedestrians, and put them all together. And here, this is very interesting. This is the Dawn Treader. That little boat you saw there is what we call the footprint boat. It's exactly the same size as the Dawn Treader, and that was the boat that was taken to sea to get the wake from the Dawn Treader, and the computer version of the Dawn Treader was superimposed upon it. Now, this is Reaper Cheap, who goes through many iterations, and the Minotaur. You can see the changes they start at. These are the kind of design phases, and the way we see we're playing with the eyes, the mouth, trying to get the shape correct, and this is the finished product. Here again is the footprint boat. This is a huge shot on the film, as you can see, but it starts out as a very modest effort with a small tug. But that small tug is, as I said, exactly the same size as the Dawn Treader. Here we are in the middle of the shot as we're going through across the boat. The boat is on the quayside, and you can see, if you look carefully, all the people watching. And then this last part, which is the head of the boat, was done against a blue screen. And there's an early iteration of Reaper Cheap, minus his fur, and you can see, I think he will develop as we go. Again, this scene was shot against a blue screen. It looks as though they were miles up in the air, but they weren't, just about 10 feet up in the air.
And here we have one of our two naiads, which were done by a visual effects house called The Mill in London. These are creatures we actually invented for this film and did not appear in the book.
Yeah, we wanted to add some more elements of fantasy and magic to try and, you know, go back to the Lion and the Witch. So this was an addition. And here you see, this is a shot of the Dawn Treader, but there is its footprint boat. That's what the second unit filmed. They went all up and down the coast of Queensland shooting that footprint boat, and on the computer put the Dawn Treader. And again, we shot this almost in a bare stage. You can see the wonderful statues of the lords holding their heads, and the rest was all created. And this gives you an idea of what the sword fight was like. Him fighting against nothing and then fighting against a developing Reaper Cheap. This was shot in New Zealand, again with our boat, our footprint boat, and you can see how we changed the environment to make it more exquisite than it was, to make it look like an archipelago, the lead into Lone Island. And there it is finished with the archipelago and the full Dawn Treader. But you can see in the wake that would have been the footprint boat. And they're on their way to the Magician's Library, which was done for us by Senate. Now, we built all the walls of this set, but no ceiling. And as you can see, Georgie was acting underneath a green screen. And here are the designs as the sequence developed. The first of all, the drawings, and then the color, the concept, and eventually the snow, and that was the finished product. We did build quite a lot of this set. It was just the roof we didn't. And here you can see with the skies, trying to give skies, give interesting looks to it, cloud formations. Here are our duffel puds, our midgets, as it were, or with their big feet. That was very complicated. They were shot on a stage, just head and shoulders, and then miniaturized down, and the big feet were added. Here's our magician's garden. We based it on a sort of French mansion, and also these strange kind of hedges and whatever, topiaries, came from research we found of a garden in France. And there is putting together the real actors here and then trying to graft in the actual duffel pads. They all had to be sort of drawn in and placed in and then animated in. That was very complicated, and that took months before we even began to see shots of this. So it was extremely complicated, and here's an end product of them bouncing along. And now this is a look at the magician's map, which was a 3D map. We shot something very simple, a piece of blue on the ground, and all these things were later added. This, I think, was Ramandu, and here's the magician with the blue star. And now, again, this is into CGI computer land. There's the rough sea we got with our little boat. And now you can see being added to our little boat is a different sky, a different feeling, rain, and a lot more water. And this is us on the stage shooting against blue screen. And you can see dimly in the background the beginnings of the water plate. This is Reaper Cheap and Company going to Golden Island. We had to put the Dawn Treader in the background, and that's the complete animation of Reaper Cheap. And there's the complete animation of the island, but that's what we shot against. We just shot on empty water, nothing in the background, and added these other ingredients. And here is Goldwater Island, that's finished, but again, there was no sea there. We were on the edge of a quarry with green screen behind us. There are the actors working on it, and then this is what they were really up against. And then you can see them, the way that they matted in, built in the sea, the background sea, plus the Dawn Treader. And this is a big moment for us when Dragon yanks Edmund up. Again, Edmund was just pulled up by a crane and the dragon was left afterwards. Again, this is the big scene by the waterfront, by the bonfire. These are the finished versions, and this is the plates we shot, just empty plates. Look very bizarre, just shooting air, and then these plates were put behind these computer-generated creatures. This is one of my favorite shots. Started out simply as our footprint boat chugging along and then developed into the full Dawn Treader and the full dragon pulling it along. Never thought we could achieve this, but there it is. And this is Ramandu. Again, that was something real from Ramandu, and it transformed from this into this with all sorts of waterfalls added and different colors and a beautiful new sky with twilight in it. And again, on the stage, we look as though they're walking across a deep ravine. All they're walking across is a bridge that Barry Robison built, and in the background and the foreground are all the other elements. This is how Liliandl began, as an electric light, and Senet made her into this gorgeous creature surrounded by a wonderful glow. And again, you can see that we shot it against blank screen, and this beautiful twilight sky was put in afterwards. And here is a lot of NPCs' work, the aftermath of the battle, when the battle was over. And we were trying all sorts of different mist levels, because when we shot it, as you can see here, there was no mist at all. And we just had to experiment after we'd shot it with the amount of mist we put on. There's another big moment with Eustace the dragon attacking the sea serpent. They were done by NPC. And as you can see, different elements, the flame element brought on. And this is the stuff of, you can see various stages of the sand dune. We built the sand dune on the back lot of the studio, and here comes Eustace the dragon. This is the work that was going on the stage, just with lots of water being thrown at the actors, and you can see the beginnings of the sea serpent being put in behind him. Here is one of our real 3D effect shots with the arrow. And here you can see the way we were constructed Dark Island, which is the place where the green mist lived and the place where we had to go and win our battle. You can see it developing, and here's early versions of the serpent being placed in with this complicated shot with the arrow and with the Dawn Treader. NPC did most of the sea battle, those huge wide shots. You can see this developing one with the sea serpent and the boat. The water coming in, the different grades of mist. You can see the finished animal beating against Edmund. Again, more development of Dark Island. That's how it looked when we shot Edmund, just against blue. And here is a finished shot of the serpent whacking against Edmund. And here is an aerial shot of Ramandu, which was created by the Senet Visual Effects House. This is the blue light came up, which empowered Edmund's sword to kill the serpent. They created this from nothing, and here we are with MPC and all that great detail of the wet Reaper-cheep. And now here is the last scene, which is kind of a miracle, I think. This is frame-stored. It did this. Here you can see the early version of the wave. You can see they diagrammed it out to this and how it becomes not the wave that would never break. There it is in its next stage with no background to it, just working on the dynamics of the wave itself. You can see how the dynamics increase. And now we put in what we shot, which is the four actors just on the beach, placing the wave in. And now we've got a background. You can begin to see some little mountaintops. We shot this. We shot this from a helicopter, and we shot this for real with real shadows and sun. Reaper Cheat was added. You can see the different stages he went through. And then hopefully added here, yes, there's Aslan's shadow. But all that was shot live by us, and there's another angle. This is what it was like without the wave, and there it is with the wave. There it is with the green screen, and then without green screen. There it is with a tennis ball being Aslan, and then with Aslan. Again, green screen, and a man in blue being Aslan, and then the real Aslan.
Is this your country?
So you can see how crazy it was to shoot it. What an odd-looking set it was. And there we go. Again, you can see the various stages of it all, mixing the wave without the wave, Aslan without Aslan, Aslan being animated and speaking and moving. That's what Lucy was playing against, that sort of version. And you can see it being developed and diagrammed, the fur being added. I think there were scores of people working on this, just on the fur alone. It's just beautiful, the fur. And again, the way they put her hand into the cheek of Aslan. And now again, building this shot. That's what we shot, and here's the dynamic of the tunnel in the wave. You see they had to add the boots and all this. Very comical. And now we're starting to build the shot. This is what it became. This is it sort of pretty much finished. And now here they are trying to match the wet with the dry. Different ingredients, so they're moving the actors around so that the dry version will match perfectly with the wet version. So all these elements are mobile.
We had close to 2,000 effect shots. You get an idea of how intricate and how pre-planned, how precise, but it's pure magic in our film.